Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Tanzil Mirza. So finally now it's time to improve our program. For the last few lectures we've been discussing about this inspect element and this persistent warning every time, no, this key prop. So it's time to improve our code, it's time to fix this problem now. Alright, let me tell you something about keys. Actually what happens is that keys are important properties, or we can say it's an important property which should be added while rendering a list of data. No, that's what React is telling us to do. So it is actually a default property that React expects to find on an element, no matter it's a component, it's a custom component. It doesn't matter whether it's your custom component or a default HTML JSX component. Especially while mapping elements into JSX using this map function. So this key property actually helps React to update its list effectively. It tries to compare the existing DOM with a virtual DOM, that which elements have changed, what to render, where the changes have occurred. That's why we need keys, to so that React can manage its list of elements more effectively. So it's a property, as I told you. So let me add a new property over here. Before this, let's add keys. Okay, the keys property. Just a minute. Yeah, the keys property, actually it's key only, key property, and like this. Now what we will pass into this key property, what we are going to pass here, something unique will pass here, which is something unique. See, most of the time, see what's happening here, we have hard coded this array. Name is skill. Okay, it's a manual, it's our personalized, it's our customized code. But most of the time, you might be reading data from a database. And at that time, definitely, there are high chances that you're already having a unique ID, a primary key over there. So at that time, it becomes quite easy for you, because you already have a unique column over there, and you can pass that column right here. But the problem is that in this particular example, we don't have anything unique here. We are not reading anything from the data. From the database, we don't have any primary key or anything like that. So here we can pass, what we can pass here, we can pass name. In this case, we have name unique. No, we can pass here a name, but the problem is that you cannot pass name, because it's not necessarily that name always remain unique. Later in the program, suppose I want to add one more object. I added Abhishek. There's one more Abhishek. Suppose there's one more Abhishek in my class, and he's fluent in maybe Java. So in this case, it will create a problem. So we cannot use name as key. It's apparent. Apparently, we cannot use name as key. We have to find out something else. Now, try to guess. Make some guesses. Try to figure out what can we use here. Okay, we can pass index here. Can we pass index here? Yes, sure, we can pass index over here, but there is a problem with this index also. It's unique. Okay, I agree, it's unique for every element 0 1 2 3, but the problem is that the moment one of the elements get deleted, no, this is 0, let me show you, this is 0, this is index 1, this is index 2, all right this is index 3, sorry, this thing. And let me add few more. Maybe there was one more, index 3, and that was index 4. So we can pass index over here, but the problem is that with index also, the problem is that the moment one of the elements get deleted, suppose I deleted this, Alright, I deleted this element. Now the index will change. It will become 2. It will be readjusted. Because arrays always start with index number 0 and it's consecutive in nature. All of us know that arrays are continuous and contiguous in nature. So every time you delete something here, now again if you added something here, see it becomes 2 and it becomes 3. So using index is also not a solution, because this index is also readjusted every time you add or delete a new element or JSON inside this array. So you cannot use even this index. So what can we do? So in this case, let's remove this thing and let's press Ctrl Z. Done. Okay, let's remove everything from here. Okay, let it be. It's in comment section. It's working. It's still working. Okay. So what we can do? We can introduce a new ID over here. A new variable we can introduce over here. Okay. As I already told you that most of the time you don't need to worry about that, because most of the time there will be something unique you will get, because most of the time you must be reading from a file or maybe from database. So don't worry, let's make a new field, ID. Okay, and I'm just randomly hitting my keyboard. I'm not creating any specific ID, not in a specific. I'm just simply hitting my keyboard. See, let's add IDs for these also. And the last one, ID, this one, something like, okay, I haven't saved the code yet, because let me first show you the warning, the previous warning, the persistent warning it's giving me. Okay, now the warning has gone because I've saved the code. Alright, we have run the code once, so now. Okay, the moment I save this code, we have now ID here and we have passed, not ID, we'll pass this single person dot ID here. Now let's see if it gives me error. See, there's no error now. The error has gone forever now, cause we have passed a key value, a key property to every element, and it works like the previous code, is working perfectly fine. See, and now without warning. So this is how you remove that warning, and this is the reason why we use key. So thank you so much for watching this video. I'll be back with some new concepts and some new videos. If you have any doubt, you are absolutely free to write this in the comment section below, and thank you so much.